Welcome to all of you on this session of solar knowledge. Today, I am going to teach you regarding the difference between the net metering and the gross metering. And more important than that, I am going to show you how to calculate the impact on the money saved or money earned through solar when it is net metering and money saved or spent when it is gross metering. So let us start. The net metering is the situation in which a consumer can connect his or her solar system with the grid so that you can take electricity from the grid when your solar system is not generating, and you can give the electricity to the grid when your solar system is generating more electricity than you are consuming. Now, there's a difference between the net metering and the gross metering or the net billing. I'll show you that what is the difference, and then we'll do the calculation. So what you're trying to do is you're actually having a solar PV system. So let's say this is your solar PV system, and this system is connected with a house, and this solar system can be on the rooftop. I'm just showing a separate here, and then there is a grid from where you are taking the power. Okay, so there's a grid from where you're taking the power. So basically power is coming here and here. So this is solar system is connected here. The grid is supplying the power to the home. So this is how your typical grid connected system looks like. Now what happens if it is, suppose your requirement of the solar system is, let's say 151 units, that's total consumption that you want, and of your home is 151 units of electricity, and you are generating, let's say, about 100 units of electricity using solar. Okay, so solar is supplying here, you are taking 151 units. So what does it mean? That the remaining 51 units are going to come from the grid. So that is how your grid connected system will work, and in your net metering case, you are going to get net 51 units of electricity. Now in the case when you are actually not consuming as much as generated by the solar. So suppose, let us take another example where your now solar is generating, let's say 150 units. Okay, your solar is generating 150 units, and your consumption in this case is only 50 units. So your net is now 100, so 150 is coming from here, you are only consuming 50 units. So what will happen is that the remaining 100 units, you are going to the grid. Okay, so you are going to the grid, and in the net metering system what happens, you can actually bank it, store it, and use this 100 units at some other rate. Use this 100 units which you have supplied to the grid at some other time when your consumption is higher than the generation. Now both this coming of electricity from the grid and the electricity going to the grid is all at the same rate. Therefore, if you are saving 100 or banking 100 units to the grid, you can take 100 units from the grid. But when it comes to the gross metering, it is not like that. So this was the case for the net metering. What happens in the gross metering, whenever a situation like this happens, that your solar PV generates 150, you consume 50, the government takes this 100 units at certain rate, and that rate is normally, let's say, 3 rupees. So the net, you will get the money from the electricity that you are supplying to the grid is at 100 into 3 rupees. And I'll show you a step-by-step calculation a little later. But then you are not banking this electricity, you are getting the rate of electricity adjusted in your bill on that month. And the other case, when your generation is 100, so the electricity sold to the grid is at 3 rupees, but when your consumption is 150, your generation is 100, then your net that you are going to take from the grid is 50 units. Now this 50 units will be charged not with this 3 rupees rate which you sold to, but you are going to be charged at 7 rupees or 10 rupees or 8 rupees depending on different category of consumer. So it is clear that you are getting electricity from the grid at much higher rate, and when you are selling solar electricity to the grid, it is at lower rate. As a result of that, the net impact is, in case of gross metering, you are going to lose some money. How? So let us take an example of a person, Ramesh, who has just installed solar system and is very happy with its solar system because it is going to save him money. What will happen to the Ramesh electricity bills when the policy suddenly gets changed from net metering to gross metering? This is the example where there are, let us draw the four columns: the total electricity consumption, the solar generation, the net usage by the Ramesh, and the cumulative bank. I am assuming that the rate at which you are getting electricity from the grid is 7 rupees, and therefore suppose there are 5 months, January, February, March, April and May, and the respective consumption of those 5 months are given here: 151, 100, 100, 64 and 281, that is the consumption, total consumption. For the Ramesh, the solar generation for those 5 months is 100, 75, 164, 181 and 100. As a result of that, the net usage of the month will be 51, that is the difference between the total consumption and solar generation. So the difference is 51, the next February month 25. The month of March, the solar generation is more than the total consumption. So 164 is generation, 100 is consumption. So the net is minus 64, which actually tells that the 64 units are actually exported to the grid. And in the case of April, again, there is a net exported to the grid, 117 units. And in the month of May, the total consumption of Ramesh is 281 units, but solar generation is only 100 units. Now, there were 181 units in the bank. As a result of that, 181 units in the bank is utilized now, and the payment that Ramesh has to make is only for the fixed charges. The typical electricity bill is the fixed charge plus variable charge. So Ramesh has to only pay fixed charges for the month of May. So this was the case for the net metering. Let us see what happens in the net billing or the gross metering. Now the electricity, total electricity consumption and the solar generation remain same in this case also, in the gross metering also. Your net usage from the grid also remains same: 51, 25, minus 64, minus 117 and 181. So minus 64 and minus 117 means that you are exporting electricity to the grid. But what is the difference in this case is that you cannot make any bank, you cannot store it. As a result, whenever you are exporting to the grid, you will get paid from the DISCOMs at a rate, let's say 3 rupees per unit, and this rate is yet to be fixed. We do not know exactly how much, but it is certainly lower than the grid electricity rates. As a result of that, the net impact will be that you will see the total bill for the Ramesh in case of gross billing will be in the month of January 557, 375, March 8, in April it will be minus 151, and in the May it will be 1467. So if you compare the bill of Ramesh when it is net billing, for the total bill of the Ramesh in the 5 months when it is net metering, it is 1532 rupees, while the total bill of Ramesh when it is net billing or gross metering is 2256 rupees. So you see that the Ramesh ends up paying more money when it is gross metering for exactly same solar system, for exactly same electricity consumption at his home. And therefore, this is the difference between the net metering and the gross metering. So in summary, in the net metering, you can actually bank your electricity, excess electricity with the DISCOMs. In the gross metering, you cannot bank it. In the net metering, the rate of taking electricity and the rate of giving electricity remain same. In the net billing or the gross metering, the rate of taking electricity is always higher as compared to the rate of giving electricity to the grid. As a result of that, the gross metering tends to be more expensive for the consumer as compared to the net metering option. I hope this you understand the difference between the net metering and gross metering, and how it is going to affect the various consumers. And If you enjoyed this discussion and this explanation, please leave a comment, give your feedback, and if you're not subscribed to this channel yet, please do so and press on the bell button so that you can get the latest update about the solar knowledge and the news. Thank you very much for watching this.